This is our journey. From the beginning, we understood that together, we are stronger. We believed in ourselves and our own power. But as the path unfolded, we realized we didn't have to walk alone. We knew we were meant to become something more. And so the tribe was born. We joined forces, built each other up, created a safe place where everyone belongs. Through all the ups and downs, tears and doubts, lessons and victories, we discovered the importance of never giving up.
Finding our magic is an inside job.
We were never afraid to start over. Rising from the ashes.
As we all know, it's hard coming to a new country, starting from the scratch.
It's tough sometimes, but it makes you alive.
Slowly we embrace the unknown instead of fearing it. And we let the eyes of our inner child guide the way. And even as we found ourselves completely alone, we remained united. And rediscovered the true meaning of being together, of being a tribe. Troyer may be the place where everything began, but every journey has a turning point. A moment when you discover unexpected truths. Suddenly we realize home was never a place. Our quest for roots has come to an end. The tribe is our home and the seed of all things, setting deep wherever we go.
Are doomed in a lot of ways. I was doomed.
In 2013, the first event happened, we had 14 nationalities. Today, we work with 180 nationalities, which is pretty cool. Nowadays, THU is a global organization that empowers creators, but started as an event. What you saw here was just a video about the beginning of THU, that was an event in Troy. And the reason I'm here is to explain how I build a community, right? You guys want to understand how I build a cult. Because THU is a cult. So basically, the way I describe how I managed to do this is fundamentally that I will tell it with no layers. I do stuff because I do this because I care. Everything we do at THU is to solve a problem in our community. So everything you will see that we are doing, any project, is what are the problems that we are trying to solve. So we listen. So the reason that we start to be a community is because the people that join us, they understand that I'm there to solve a problem they have. It's about caring. And that's the reason that a lot of communities, they don't succeed in my opinion, and I've been in contact with several organizations trying to understand what's the problem. And the most important thing that I realize that is missing is caring. A lot of people, they don't care. So with the THU we do, and this seems that it's pretty obvious, but it's not obvious because it's destroyed us in a lot of ways, we care. We go and we listen. And when you start listening, there is like a lot of things that happen go to you, and this you need to make choices. So, and the way you analyze all the problems is the way that you show that you care or not. And it is the difficult part of THU. So nowadays, I have a structure now. When I started in 2013, I was me alone and another first girl, part-time. Now we have a structure of 25 people working full-time on this. And we have 11 projects happening during the year. So we started, and our core is artists. And now we are, our core is creators. So from 2013 until 2023, we change. What changes is we are in a worse position than we were in 2013, to be honest. The world is worse nowadays. It's more complicated. So we needed to change everything that we've been doing in the last 10 years to adapt to what is happening now in our industry. Why I'm doing this, to be honest? Because 20 years ago, I discovered a project called Creative Cities from UNESCO, where they show that the creative industries are the only industry that can rebuild a system following economics and social. So if we have more creators, more creative industries around the world, we'll have less Donald Trumps, less Putins, less Bolsonaro. And this is a problem. So in Portugal, I've been advocating the Portuguese government and the Portuguese itself to actually care about the Portuguese industry. And then, sorry, the creative industry. But there is a problem at the end of the day, and that is education. Education, the creative education around the world is really, really bad. So what THU as a community has been trying to do nowadays is let's together solve the problem. Let's together trying to inspire others so we can actually show that we are important. So the creative industry should be mainstream. But this is not the point of my topic. The point of my topic is how I build this community at the end of the day. So, the story of THU was this. I made this event. I cried a lot during the event. I realized that we changed. I found something really special because at the end of the day, I made an event that I didn't find outside. An event without no VIPs. Everyone was equal. Speakers and attendees, they are equal. So I should take care of the attendees the same way I should take care of the speakers. And this was a pretty complicated that happened. So suddenly, I had the best of the best artists around the world seated together during 5 days with the attendees like normal people. There's no way about the attendees. So that was the number one. I was pretty scared about this because I didn't know how to do it. What happens? And during that first event, I realized that we could do it. This is a change. So when the event ends, I get a job to all my people in the company and I start this project. Okay, so how should I go now to the next step? In that 14 nationalities, I realized that everyone was subject to the same thing. there was no opportunities of jobs. In 2013, there was not like this. LinkedIn didn't exist the way it does. There was no opportunities. So everybody was suffering like there is no jobs for anyone. It's really hard to go. And we worked a lot. And as a creators, we are introverts. It's pretty complicated for us to go to events and to speak and to get connections. At least for me, I'm really introvert. I'm an introvert. I'm scared to be on the stage, to be honest. So I made an event for myself, an event where I should be confident to talk with anyone. So the second thing was free alcohol.
The best decision.
And the true story was, this was not supposed to happen, but in 2013, at some point, I was supposed to have the sponsorship of the city hall of Setúbal, and they were supposed to offer me alcohol and food. And 24 hours before the event started, they called me and said, I can only offer one thing, alcohol or food? I said alcohol. And it was amazing, because again, I didn't know that that was the secret to actually unlock a lot of stuff. So basically, I built this community, trial and error, like let's do it fast. So, as a Portuguese, I'm always like, yes, this is Portugal. I didn't expect to make a global brand. I didn't know how to go out and actually to make sure that people understood what I was seeing. I was seeing an opportunity for us to actually show that we are important. So that was the thing I was doing in 2013. How to show this to the world, what to expect. And I had a lot of hope. So after this 2013, the alcohol, the VIP thing happened, and seeing all the connections that happened, because the truth is, and this is true, like, if you are part of the tribe, you can go to any place in the world, you just text someone from the tribe, and they open the door for you. That's why we call it the tribe. Super powerful. Like, we are like the... That is the connections that we made, teach you, are really, really, really deep. And only we always saying that until you go there, it's hard to explain. Because it's really hard to explain this, it's true. There are three people from the tribe here, they know, they can tell you after this. I didn't invite them, they can hear by themselves. Okay. So after this, 2013, I made this in Troy. Just to let you guys know, there was... and the true story of THU that 10 years, because I think I will spend the next 15 minutes beating this 10 years, that's why I talk fast. We made the first event with no money. People ask, how did you make this? I had zero money, 0 euros in my bank account when I started Trojan Horse was Unicorn. By the way, why was Trojan Horse Unicorn is the name? Because I needed a stupid name. One of the foundations of the project was, I want to do something non-corporate. I want to do something that people don't understand and they go there to find. No expectation. What the fuck is this? So the name needed to be stupid. That's the reason I choose Trojan Horse was Unicorn. So everything started with this. If I want to do something for creators, no VIP, no bullshit, let's start with a stupid name. Let's be stupid by ourselves. So this is our starting point. So I registered Trojan Horse was Unicorn 2 days ago, 10 years ago, 25th of January. So the first event happened was mind-blowing. I ended the event with 111,000 euros minus in my bank account. So, another true story. Doing events is terrible, so please don't do events. And I was a bit doomed. But suddenly, I put the ticket sales 2 months later for 2014, and I almost sold out in 48 hours. So I received the money back. And now, at the time, I already had 30 countries. And during this 2013-2014, there was one attendee that went to the first event, Jack Wilson, who was working in Germany, and he said, I want you to bring THU to Berlin. I said, what the fuck? THU to Berlin? I just started this in my hometown in Troy, not even Lisbon, and he wanted me to go to Berlin. I said, I don't have any money. I have 111,000 euros minus in my bank account. So, what the fuck, I should go to Berlin? I can't even know how to eat now. I need to find ways to eat. I said, no worries, I convinced my company they will sponsor everything, I already rent a bar, come. But now I'm inviting, I'm being invited to go to German Berlin. And I went there, and it was raining, I was passing by with the Uber, and suddenly there was a line of almost 400 people waiting to go to the bar. I said, what the fuck? What is this? This is the event of Trojan Horse, the first gathering. I went there. For me, the event was terrible. Really bad organized. Like, and they normally I like to give stuff. So for me, it was free alcohol at the event. And in Berlin, the guys in the bar were charging like €6 for a beer. So I was like, people will destroy me. This is outrageous. This is crazy. After 3 hours in the event, I was like pretty upset. Suddenly, I went to the hotel that they paid me, and I started seeing messages from all over the social network. This is amazing, Toyota is amazing, this is fantastic. And I was like, okay, what's the beginning? Again, luck. Because after this, I started to make gatherings around the world. And companies started paying me. And so I went to Tokyo, I went to LA, I went to London, Paris, Varsovia, Croatia. Where else? Taiwan government invited us to go there, so it was really cool. So again, luck. And the reason people go to the gathering, and I remember in Japan that was pretty particular, was we made a special, after this, just to let you know, the last gathering we made cost me for 6 hours event, 80,000 euros. Because what I try to do is an experience. I want to give back. So even for me, like at some point, when you are coming here, I'm leaving schedule. At some point, we start to have a drop-off of 20% in the gathering. So we start to ask 10 euros for people to go. And because people go and they subscribe, but they don't come. The funny thing was, when they arrive there, we give the 10 euros back with the message. And this kind of particular detail that you made during this journey of 10 years made people spread the word and try to, these guys care. So the community was building 1 million ways to actually connect all the dots. So the gatherings happened, and THU 2014 happened, and 2015 happened, and I stopped THU. At the time in 2015, I was minus 500,000 euros. Yes, minus 500,000. And the true story that happened in a Portuguese newspaper at the time was pretty famous in Portugal, that when the media asked me why I was shutting down THU, I asked, how can I do this when the only help I had from the Portuguese government, from the city halls and the government itself was two pigs. The only sponsor received in 2015 was two pigs for a Berlin. I just was in an event with Teddy Cosmary from Web Summit. I was in the same event that they signed the contract was me and Paddy Cosgrave. And Paddy Cosgrave received 10 million euros and all the, and I received two picks. That's really crazy. So I shut down the event. I was then minus 500 euros. So as you see, building the community takes a lot of efforts when you're building the community. I remember I was in Singapore, my wife was living in Singapore. And suddenly I received a message from the Portuguese Secretary of State, João Vasconcelos, that passed away a couple of years ago. And he said, why the fuck you do that? That is not the way to do business. I didn't know the guy. I said, why are you insulting me? Like, I did the right thing. Like, I spent 3 years, like, contacting you guys, and you guys didn't care about the creator. They don't care about the creative industry. And I just said the truth. I said, no, that is not the way. So I spent 5 hours collecting all the emails for 3 years, and I sent to him. You know, like, what the fuck, that's true. So he invited me to go to his office at the time. And we started off. And it was the beginning of a new change of the way we interact. So I spent more 2 years in Portugal. And suddenly, I was starting to receive offers from all over the world to host THU. That was another thing that was a lucky thing. And suddenly, I went to Malta. It was the worst experience ever. Never make events in Malta, I don't care. It was pretty cool for my friends, because the funny thing about me is I love to be Portuguese, I love Portugal, but it's terrible to be Portuguese. And another secret I have is I don't listen to Portuguese. It's another secret I have. Portuguese, in a lot of ways, they are hard to grow. So when people ask, what is your secret about THU, is until now, because now I work in Portuguese, but for 8 years, I shut down all the doors about Portuguese. Pure Portuguese trying to get my business with me and say no. It was hard. But the reason was the mentality. It's another thing. Like, the culture and the community, people believe in you if they believe they can grow. thing I have to do it is like, okay, I'm going down, I have minus 500,000 euros. At the time, I shut down the event, which is another thing. In 2015, at the last day of Q2, I announced to everyone that I was closing Q2 for it. I cried on stage for 2 hours. This is a true story. Because I didn't, I had to say to everyone, I didn't get the support for doing this madness. And the dream to build a community, I felt nobody cares. But at the time at the audience, there was a guy from Lenovo, Grayson Davies, was that specific year was the first time I was receiving a sponsor from an organization, was 50K. Small. For me at the time, I was already minus, I had to do the event, 50K was good, but small. So I shut down the event, and the funny thing was another lucky thing. When I shut down the event at this specific moment, everyone said to me, this is going to continue. And the guy just literally gave me a check of $10,000 in front of me. And suddenly we did a lot of stuff at THU, and we are giving like some mics, and people start giving money for the mics. Like the Portuguese give 5 euros, 10 euros, the foreigners 200 euros. It's true, 2 euros. And at the time, the guy from Adobe said, sleep, rest, in 2 weeks, let's talk in LA. And I was like, come on, I just said that I don't have money to 500,000. Another guy wanted me to go to LA. How the hell will I find the money to go to LA? So I went to LA, I found the money, I asked my wife. She didn't. Actually, I'm here because my wife, she has a lot of money. And so my wife gave me the money, I flew to LA, and the guy came to me and said, how much do you need to continue this madness? And then I said, 500,000 euros. And I said, okay, a check of 500,000 euros. And now. So the community, building a community takes time. I was lucky enough in 3 years to build a community because the community saved me. They saved me because I care. And one of the problems is a lot of communities, a lot of people that are building communities, they don't care. That's a true story. It's not they care because, no, it's good to be a community, but do you really know what is a community? Do you really know why you are doing this? What is your KPI? What is success for you? Why do you measure that you are doing something good? For me, doing something good is helping someone. For me, it's managing the way that I know that someone is helping someone. It's a big giving back process. So, this guy from Lenovo saw that what we are doing there, somehow, is powerful. And so Lenovo gave me this money, but let's be clear, like they receive the money back, because in 2 years they became the number one seller in the media entertainment industry. Because they closed deals at THU directly with the big guy that from Double Negative, from Polygon, from Mountain School. Because one of the things they realized that business is about relationships. And at the end of the day, you need to go to the place where the relationships are, the true relationships. And I mentioned like 10 minutes ago that we are a cult. At THU, the relationship, they know you. So they do business with the people they know. And normally, another thing that is a success of THU, I said before that we give a lot of stuff, but I only give stuff when you give first. So there's no free tickets at THU. No, we are really, until you pay, until you show that you are willing to do something for you, I will not give you nothing for you. It's our rule. Like, and accountability is another thing that we do. So the tribe members, they know. For example, for the career camp that is the online project, they can invite one person. You know, they allow you to invite one person. But that person that you invite fucked up, you are fucked up. So this is really interesting because only 20% of the tribe, they gave one plus one. They show they don't trust anyone that will really do the right job. And this is stuff, I say this like confident, but every time I have this idea and I decide, I'm scared to implement this because this is powerful. This is powerful. Like what message I'm sending to the tribe, what message I'm sending outside. But the true thing is, it's happening. after 10 years, people care. So we know that if you go to THU, it's because you have passion about yourself. It's because you care. And because you care, when you go to event, everybody knows, I went to event yesterday, I received a free ticket, I went there for a meeting, and I went. Everybody knows that Web Summit is all there. I know everybody went to Web Summit, I'm assuming there are other type of events. So you go to events, you are there, it's cool, and you want to go home and just have dinner. Normally, like, it's a social thing to be there 2 or 3 hours, and it's true, right? It's the way we manage events. When you go to THU, we spend 6 days, 24 hours, non-stop with these people. It's another secret, how you build a community. You need to spend time with people. So, one of another secrets of THU, I always choose places where you can't leave. It's a trap. So, it's another thing, like, people ask, why try it? Because it's far away from everything. When you take the ferry and you land, you don't want to leave, you don't know how to leave. So, now we are going to do in Barcelona a project called Creative Circle in La Mola. Why choose La Mola? Because it's 40 minutes from Barcelona. It's in the middle of nowhere, like a campus, you can't leave. And we always choose locations that you can't leave. Because if you are here to actually do something, you need to understand how you do things, like to make connections. How you make connections, spending time. How you spend time if you want to be 2 hours, 3 hours having a conversation and you are need to go because you have a lunch or a dinner or something else. So that's another thing. What we do at THU, that's why the gatherings that I mentioned, we stopped doing the gatherings by the way. The gatherings, you decide, okay, the challenge was, if the secret of THU is people need to spend time and to connect, and I only have 6 hours, how the fuck are you make an event a success in 6 hours? And that's why we spend, okay, we need to do an experience. And let's come to the next secret, that everything about THU is about food. Food is the most important thing at THU. Because one of the things I realized is that a family is built on the table, the breakfast. So we make sure that when you go to THU, you have a food experience. Sometimes you succeed, and other times you don't succeed. But the main idea was that, like, build an experience based on food, spend time. So we built something called the Oasis. So we have the THU Oasis, that is the Sony Oasis. And basically the place where food and alcohol go to a place where you just go there to sit down and experience. Again, it's like the small secrets that made you connect, that make like your mindset change. And we have incredible stories, like there was a lady from Iran that I met her at THU and she told me that I spent 3 years saving money to come here. And I didn't know anyone. So, but online everybody told me that because I was scared by not knowing anyone physical, that THU will never feel alone. And that's the kind of story that I was like, fuck. Like 3 years spending money, saving money, and came here alone from Ireland. It's pretty interesting how that all this happens. I gave a ticket for the next year, obviously. Because she spent 3 years saving, I don't want her to spend more 3 years saving, but she gets a job at THU or she gets connections at THU, that's something that happened in like another team. Like if you go to an event, what's your expectation? A job? Improve your skills? What do you need to pay? So for me, I'm always listening to the tribe, as the community manager of THU here. That is also another secret, like why I'm doing this. At the end of the day, it's bullshit. I go to events where I ask myself, why they are doing this? Who is taking from us? What is the goal? What is the purpose? When this community, when it's an event, just it's just a promotion event, it's okay. But when it's a community building, I ask myself all the time, I stop going to events because it's terrible. When you start building events, it's like you don't want to go to events because you are analyzing everything and you don't have fun anymore. That's my problem. So I stopped doing events. So I'm saying this. The last event I went was last year in Poland from friends that invited me to go to event. And they asked me, what's your opinion? I said, this is terrible. He invited me as a speaker and a lot of people were there. and the menu is in Polish. There is no Polish in the audience, just English people. So I said, that is true. But you forgot to mention that there is no dinners organized for us. You said everything is included. And at the time, they are my friends from a big organization. And all the speakers know me and came to me like to find support. And said, oh, this is not that happened at THU, because I said, yes, but this is not THU. And they were stressed and upset about the event itself, because, and they don't want to go to the event itself, because they didn't care. So I sent a list of all the things to my friend that we should change it. And they said, thank you, but we will continue this way. Why? Because it takes a lot of time and effort to actually make the change that I mentioned to them. Just caring, it's important. Just having a buzz waiting for the attendees at the airport. We have transportations for all the attendees at the airport. It's expensive. It's, imagine like managing 1,000 people from the airport going to Troia. Takes a lot of like more team and to manage. And I said that you need to take care of the attendees. Like, take care of the attendees. People arrive at the airport, they are lost. They have a welcome person, just someone, if you don't have the transportation, just a welcome person to say, I'm here, thank you for coming, because they spend money to go to your event. The last thing, the minimum thing you can do is say thankful for them to, because they are there. So the community of THU was building these things. So, but I was saying that 2015 I shut down the event, the main event, and I decided to grow. They gave me 500,000 euros, and suddenly there was Lenovo behind me, other brands start joining, and I start like, by the way, the pandemic was the best days of my life. I love doing the pandemic. Because doing events is terrible, so again, don't do that. So in 2016, I decided to do a bigger event. I wanted to expand. My problems was, because I was stuck to the idea that the main event should be small. I can't have big events and have the same quality. If I scale, I will lose the humanity, the one. But I need money. I need to be sustainable. That's another thing. Events, any business needs to be sustainable. So I decided to do an event for 1,000 people. And was terrible. Experience in 2016. So I remember that when I did the opening ceremony, I went immediately to my room to write everything to change about that event, and I hated that event. I was there just being a zombie, like being there for people, but I knew that I was not doing something good for the community because I did a lot of mistakes. So I was suffering of what? Because we grow, we change stuff, and I was afraid that people were saying, now THU is corporate, because I was always scared to have big name behind me. I was always scared that I was going to be controlled by the corporate team. You know, when you have a sponsor, there was always a speaker from the organization opening and then this kind of stuff. And the Portuguese government always hated me because I never allowed them to be on stage. Never. And there was an event, there was two ministers, two secretaries of state doing that event opening, and I never allowed them to be on stage. Because I knew the only person that could be on stage that could send the right message was the Prime Minister. And in Malta we had the Prime Minister. Not on stage, but we made a video with him. Really cool video, actually I can show the video. No, I don't have a computer, but I will send the video. So 2016 was this, but in 2016 I wrote the idea that okay, I don't know what to do next to scale the business, to have a sustainable business, but I understand that to help everyone around the world, I need to build a platform. So in 2016, I built a plan that actually I'm implementing now in 2022. And so when people ask, what is THU? THU is a miracle. That for years and years was the main event, because it was the only way to actually continue to get the things done, to get the money, to actually implement my ideas. Nowadays, like I said, we have a lot of things happening. But in 2016, I made that, I wrote the plan, and I realized what is the next step. In 2017, I decided that was the last year in Portugal. We made another gathering around the world, and we started to go to Japan. My dream was also, again, how can I bring credibility to the tribe if I don't have access to the place that the creator was born, Japan? Like credibility, again, bringing credibility. The tribe, the community can only support you if you actually bring credibility to them. So I start going to Japan, and after 3 years I convinced Sony. I was chasing Sony. And normally it's another thing. I go and I chase the companies I want. It's really like terrible for us, but if you really want like the org to be successful, you need to choose the organization that can help you. So I'm happy to announce that next week we will have MasterCard as our main partner. Why? Because since 2 years ago I decided that my next step is to help to build the next generation of entrepreneurs. If Portugal, if any country around the world, they need to succeed in the creative industry, I need to teach creative entrepreneurs. If I need to teach creative entrepreneurs, you need to have money. Because there is no company that can be built without money. That sucks. One of the things that for me is also problematic in the Portuguese mentality is let's do a prize for the winner and your prize is 1,000 euros. So you can build a game. How the fuck you build a game with 1,000 euros or 5,000 euros? So the lack of mentality about what is needed in our industry, it's terrible. So I need MasterCard. Now with MasterCard, I think I have the power to start helping the entrepreneurs in our industry. That's something interesting. And the community I built around the world was built on this. Was built upon these small details that make the difference and connect. And nowadays, like I was saying, like we have the main event that you saw here. We have the event that is going to happen in Japan in September that is just focusing storytelling. Only focusing storytelling. You have two projects online, spring and fall, called Career Camp, Career Development. That is now the biggest online event to career development, where my goal was how to humanize the digital experience, how to make sure that you can actually use the online experience, humanizing the online experience, because that's something that you saw during the pandemic. At some point, all the events were online, there was no connections made online, right? How the hell do you make the connections online? So my problematic was, everybody wanted us to replicate the main event online, and I explained to all the brands, it's impossible, because the secret of the issue is time and money. I can oblige people to be together 12 hours, 14 hours, and I can oblige them to drink. That's impossible. There is no peer pressure. It's important to be. We have a lot of non-alcohol things for people, obviously, but it's important. So we came up with the idea of, okay, let's humanize the digital experience and convince all the brands that the goal is not a speaker being online talking to 3,000 strangers. The goal is to convince them to spend time with 10 people, doing memberships, doing portfolio in small groups. So I convinced all the organizations, Pixar, Disney, Riot, Blizzard, to be online and to bring not the speakers but the teachers, the introverts, to be online helping and guiding and talking and making connections like small groups. I mean, if it's a small group, I can ask one and I remember it. And Career Camp happens in the pandemic, and then now it's becoming our biggest social project because it's a place we can help more people that can travel, especially from us. That's another thing. So we have Career Camps program spring and fall. Why we have two now? That's another thing, because you realize that a lot of these young kids, the mental health of them, they fall after these events. Because you go to events, you get hyped, you receive a lot of praise, a lot of energy, and suddenly you go back to your reality. Hello. And that's disturbing, because you start to have a lot of fears. So you realize that only in 1 year, I will have a chance to show my portfolio, all my projects again. So it's a lot of time, so people start to lose a lot of energy. So we decided to do a mini play. So instead of 1 year gap, we have pinpoints of 6 months, so these young kids can actually always have the support and try to solve, again, the drop and the lack of confidence. We have Greater Circle in Barcelona. That is a project just focusing entrepreneurship and trying to solve a problem in our industry that is the female gender problem. It's focusing on females. At least 80% of the attendees will make sure that are females. To make sure that we can have more and more female leaders in our industry and start to have a change. And the way we are going to do this is I'm raising money to have scholarships to make sure that I can choose the people I want there. That's another thing. I want to make sure that even the Japan event, part of the Japan event is invitation only. Because the funny thing was, when we start before the pandemic, this is a real interesting story. Japan is fancy, everybody wants to go to Japan. So we make the events, the tickets open to everyone before the pandemic, in December. The pandemic started in February, so it's in December. And we sold out in hours. And we canceled the events, so we need to give back the tickets. And we realized that the majority of people that bought the tickets, that the people that bought them, they don't care about storytelling. They're just going to go to the teacher events. So, I'm trying to solve a problem about the next generation of storytellers, and I'm not helping anyone because everyone that comes to the events are focused in just connecting because they are used to this. So how the hell I will solve this problem? Because there's a problem now in your life. There's a lack of stories. There's a lack of good projects. How can you help the creative industries if you don't have good projects? There's a lot of people who want to do stuff, but there's not enough projects. It's not insane, it's HBO, it's Netflix. This idea started at the event by the people from Netflix. They are complaining about, and they're talking about Portugal and Spain, that even Portugal at the time, they made like a project here to bring ideas. They had only 1,000 and they only selected one project. People believe that there's a lot of like ideas there, there's not. There's a lot of ideas, not good ideas. So how can I change this? That's my thing. How can we help this young? Because if you have a good idea, people will give you money. If you give money, you can start industry companies and you can actually make jobs. I'm running out of money. Okay. So going back, the community was based on all these small details. And nowadays, after the pandemic, was really good for me, like I was saying, because it allowed me not to do the main event. Because the main event took all our resources and money and didn't allow me to re-execute the plan in 2016 and to actually go to the next step of how building the community and connecting all the dots. And that's why from 2000, since the pandemic until now, we have almost 60 countries news in our community and we grow a lot the community now. And now it's a bit easier for us because the spread is there and we can ask Philippe or Jesus to host, like someone is new, please help this person to integrate. So we have like a system that integrates everyone and you make sure that everybody feels like part of something. And this is it, how I build a community in a short term. Questions? You want to know how I survived without minus 500,000 euros? Filing, people say you need to find a job or you need to change or this kind of stuff. So So surrounding yourself with people that actually believe in you, this is like the bullshit that you see in the books. It's very important. Like, nowadays I'm surrounding with people who are negative. I see that my energy is different. When I'm surrounding people more positive, so this is also super important. And I had lucky enough at the time, I was surrounded with positive people, non-toxic. So that was luck, I guess, luck. And I met my wife, that was another luck. She's super positive and she has a lot of money, also super important. They love you too, not me. They love the whole
thing. Can I ask you a question?
Yes.
You mentioned that you start in many cities. And imagine, if you start something in Lisbon, it's very different from start something in Malta, that's very different to do something in Taiwan, that's very different to do things in many other cities. Does it happen something that works in a city that doesn't work in a city, or once you do something with a certain future, you're surprised, they were like, oh, like, people think like that, or you do like this, because it's really different.
People are super...
Selfish.
So, people are selfish.
Yeah.
So, when you are in a big city, so the good thing for me, I'm starting to do things in Lisbon, but I can only do things in Lisbon when I go to a different level. If you want to build a community in Lisbon, it's possible. I don't believe that I could do it. There are people for sure that can do it. I could do it. Because Lisbon is, to me, people spread, people have their own agendas, people... And you make to make people take them to their agendas and understanding what's the real problem. And that's the reality of the issue. It's true that they are here. It's 100% sure that everyone will cry at you, because it's an emotional roller coaster where I don't allow people to sleep. And the deprivation of sleep is also another secret. Because as layers, as introverts, we have a lot of layers. So I need to make sure that I build a way to take layers from you. How I can take it, make you tired. When you are super tired, you don't control yourself, so you start to actually lose layers and start to show yourself. So that in Lisbon, it's impossible. And the community now, imagine I have a problem, I go to these guys and they go to me, but they are in Lisbon, but because I made this before. Someone that does something here, that's not a community, that's an event. So that's the thing. So that's why I can do something I know, just to let you guys know this. In 2015, when I shut down the event and I was completely upset with Portugal, I went to LA and I made a press conference in LA and I started, this was fancy, yes it's fancy, we know about this, it's over this. And we put the tickets on sale for 2016 without announcing the location. We sold out. We didn't announce the location. Tickets are on sale, 600 euros each, no discounts, no worldly tickets. Take it or leave it. We don't know the location, only know that it's in Europe. Sold out. Fastest sold out in history of YouTube. Because people trust. Doing an event or a community in a big city, it's not. That's why Web Summit, you see stuff happening in the community, but it's always a lot of like, so many hubs, that at the end of the day, there's no connection. Everybody is fighting for them. And that's the reason I'm trying to, if you have a creative industry, you have fights. That's why at THU, we don't have fights at THU. This is to imagine a way that people can actually talk and understand. Go to the, forget yourself, what is the real problem? Because the community is about problems, not about solutions. And the real problem is something that you don't want to face when you are in Lisbon. Just go to events because it's cool and you want to forget your life. This is true. And that's why I don't believe that big cities are important. And I just announced 1 year ago that I'm building a lab in Lisbon, in the center of Lisbon, that is to be used by a community already. Not to build a community from the scratch. That's the thing. This is a terrible way to inspire in the morning. So sorry. Thank you.
Yeah, we have to finish right now. I'm sure you have many questions. Andre, what's the best way?
here, present for the
community.
So awesome. Thank you.